Hey everybody, I'm James Connell, founder of Root Financial Partners, and I'm here to teach you how to create a secure retirement. Now, when most people think of retirement, they think of maybe age 67 or age 65 or maybe some age whenever they're going to start collecting Social Security. But for others, that's just not the case. Maybe they want to retire early and travel the world. Maybe there's a health event or a layoff and they just can't work even if they wanted to. What I'm going to teach you in today's video is what you need to know in order to prepare to retire early. Now, traditional retirement planning, it's contingent upon a few things, or it's helped by a few things, one of which is Social Security, another of which is Medicare. Another is just traditional withdrawal rules, or rules about how much you can take from your portfolio without running the risk, or at least minimizing the risk of running out of money. Now, here's the thing about that. All of those things are typically assuming you retire somewhere in your mid-60s. So if you're looking to retire early, the traditional rules of the game just don't exist, at least when you're first looking to retire. So if you are looking to retire early, there are four things I want you to understand so that you can understand if this is going to work best for you. The first thing I want you to understand is, what does early retirement actually mean? When some people come to me and they say, oh, I want to retire early. Well, really what that means is I want to retire from my high stress, lots of hours, really draining corporate job or something like that. They want to get out of something. They don't want to completely stop working. They just want to transition into something new. Now, that is completely different than the person who says, you know what, I'm just done with work at all. Whatever salary, whatever income I'm earning from a paycheck, that's being cut off altogether. The first one is a lot different because in that scenario, you still have income coming in. And really the name of the game in retirement planning is, how do you ensure you keep having income come in to support your needs? Well, if early retirement for you simply means going to take a new job that maybe pays less but still allows you to cover all of your bills, you don't really need to worry about retirement planning in that sense. Because what's happening is you still have a paycheck coming in that's still covering your bills, and your 401ks and IRAs and investments, they're going to continue growing for you. So you can still somewhat approach retirement planning in the traditional sense of really understanding when you're completely done working, what does withdrawals, what does income look like at that point. But for the person who says, no, I want to be completely done working, or at least done working so much that I might have a little bit of income coming in, but certainly not enough to cover my expenses, that's the true way I would look at retiring early. So when you're doing that, you need a strategy. You need to understand, where is income going to come from? How do I plan for expenses? What about not having Social Security or Medicare? But start with that. Is it truly retiring, or is it simply taking a position where there's less income going forward? Now, once you understand that, and maybe you're saying, yes, it is truly retiring early. I am done. There's no more salary. There's no more work. I'm traveling the world. I'm doing whatever I want to do. Here's the next thing you want to do. You need to determine your retirement budget. And here's what's going to be different than someone who is retiring at a traditional time. Well, with your retirement budget, you need to take a look at your expenses today. Your expenses today aren't necessarily what your income today is. So if you're still working and you're earning a healthy income, you may be paying a mortgage, you may be saving a healthy amount to your 401k, you may be putting money away to send kids to school. There's probably a lot of demands on your cash flow. What you have to think about isn't what are expenses today, it's what are expenses going to be when I retire. And not just year one of retirement, but 5 years in, 10 years in, 20 years in. How will those expenses change? For example, will a mortgage be paid off at some point, which reduces your expenses? Will college funding stop at some point, which reduces your expenses? Will savings stop when you stop working? Most likely, well, that reduces your expenses. Now, here's another thing you need to consider. If you're gonna retire before the age of 65, you need to have a strategy and a plan for health insurance. Typically, when people talk about retirement, 65 is a popular age because that's when you're eligible for Medicare. And when you're eligible for Medicare, all the money you've been paying into the payroll system for the years you've worked, that's where it starts to pay off. If you're eligible for Medicare, health insurance expenses are covered, and you still have some out-of-pocket expenses, but it's not going to be as expensive as it would be if you were to have to go get a plan on the marketplace on your own. So if you're retiring early, say age 55, well, what's your plan for expenses those first 10 years? Do you elect COBRA, which is a continuation of your policy from the workplace coverage that you had? Do you go get a plan on the open marketplace? Do you possibly qualify for some health insurance premium subsidies if you're able to keep income low in those first few years, which makes health insurance a little bit easier to afford? whatever it is, because you're not going to have Medicare quite yet, that is going to impact your retirement budget. So as you are looking at your retirement budget, it's not going to be some fixed number from, say, age 55 or age 50 all the way beyond. You're going to have to add in an extra expense for those first 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, whatever it is, until you're eligible for Medicare or eligible for health insurance from some other institution. So that's the first thing you need to look at, is how are your retirement expenses going to change? Because the 65-year-old looking at retirement doesn't have to worry about health insurance, at least to a much lesser extent. But the 55-year-old who's going to retire, that might be a pretty significant line item in the retirement budget that needs to be accounted for, at least for the first several years of retirement. Now, once you've determined your retirement budget, the next step is to understand taxes and penalties. Well, what do I mean by that? Maybe you've done a really great job of saving to your 401ks and maxing out IRAs or Roth IRAs or other retirement accounts. Well, when you do that, you have some pretty significant tax benefits for putting money into those types of accounts, but the stipulation or the trade-off is you can't always access that money, at least until age 59 and a half. So if you're looking to retire at 50, and from the age of 20 until then, you've been doing an excellent job of maxing out IRAs and 401ks, well, that's wonderful. You might have a pretty sizable account balance, but the question is, can you touch that money? Is that money available for you to collect without penalty? Because you certainly want to avoid any early withdrawal penalties, which is the penalty you would pay if you take money from your IRA before age 59 and a half. Now, there's a couple things to note with this, a couple workarounds. Number one, while the age to pull money out of 401ks and IRAs is age 59 and a half, if you retire at 55 and you had a 401k with that company you retired from, you can pull out money from that 401k and avoid the 10% early withdrawal penalty. An important thing to note here, this doesn't mean you can pull money out of any 401k. It's only the 401k that you had with that company that you retired at. The second thing to note is this doesn't mean you can retire at 54 and then pull money from that 401k at age 55. You must be with that company until you turn 55, and if you retire from them after that point, then those assets are available. So a couple planning points. Do you maybe roll over 401ks or IRAs from other institutions or from other employers into your current company's 401k to prepare to have money if needed, if you think you're going to retire early? Or at least, do you roll over enough money into your current company's 401k that you know there's enough money there, there's enough in that pot to last for the next 4.5 years until you reach 59 and a half, which means all of your other assets are available as well without an early withdrawal penalty. Another thing to note is Roth IRAs, one of the beautiful provisions on those accounts is any money that you put into a Roth IRA, you can take out at any time. No taxes, no penalties. It's just the growth on those accounts that you can't take out until age 59 and a half. So let's say for the last 20 years, you've been contributing $5,000 per year to your Roth. Now I know that was higher than some of the contribution limits in the past, but I'm just gonna use some round numbers here. Well, that Roth IRA maybe has $300,000 in it, just to throw out a round number. Of that $300,000, you have put in $100,000. That $100,000 is immediately accessible for you. So if you retire early or if you're forced out of work, you can still pull money from there. It's just the growth on that account that you can't touch. Now, one thing I like to caution people to do is try to avoid that if possible. You want your Roth IRA to keep growing for you as much as it possibly can, because the more growth you have there, the more tax-free income you're gonna have in the future. So if possible, don't tap into your Roth IRA. Let that keep compounding and growing for you. But if you do need it, then that money is there. Another thing to note is even if you do have money in a traditional IRA and you say, well, I don't have a 401k, I can put this in, or I retired before 55, there's something called 72T distribution. And what that is it's a way of accessing funds from your IRA. You have to take substantially equal payments over a period of time, either the lesser of do that for 5 years or until you reach age 59 and a half. So it is a strategy where you can still access funds penalty-free from your IRA, but there's a lot of details for that. More details than I'm gonna cover in today's video, but just know that that is an option if you need somewhere to pull funds from before the penalty expires at age 59 and a half. And then finally, taxable accounts. If you have a taxable account, there's never any penalty for accessing those funds. There are taxes, and you can almost think of short-term capital gains in a taxable account as almost being like a penalty, because you're gonna pay higher taxes than you would had you held those funds until they were long-term capital gains. But the nice thing is any funds you have outside of IRAs, Roth IRAs, 401ks, any brokerage accounts you have immediately accessible. So for people who are looking to retire early, one of the things I'll often encourage them to do is don't focus just on maxing out 401ks or IRAs. Have a balanced approach. Can you also start saving money to a brokerage account? Think of it almost like a bridge fund that's going to bridge the gap between when you retire and age 59 and a half so that you don't have to pull money from accounts that you're going to pay penalties on. So that's where you have to understand taxes and penalties. And then finally, know your withdrawal rates. So the fourth step in preparing to retire early is what withdrawal rate is reasonable. I've done other videos or talked about the fact that there's a very popular rule of 4%. And the rule of 4% says that if you have a portfolio and if it's invested a certain way, you can take 4% per year from that portfolio and be reasonably assured that that portfolio will last for the rest of your life. We've talked about other videos. There's something called Guyton's Guardrails, where he took the rule of 4%, but put some rules around it, put some guardrails around it, and said, if you do this correctly, you can increase that rule of 4% up to closer to maybe 5 to 5.5% and be reasonably assured that you're not gonna run out of money, assuming you follow the right rules in doing so year in and year out. Here's the thing though. Both of those studies, both of those papers, were assuming a traditional retirement of between 30 and 40 years. Now, if you're taking an extremely early retirement, say age 45, those withdrawal rates are probably far too high to last for the rest of your life. So as you're looking at 4% or 5%, I've had people come to me and say, okay, I'm ready to retire because I look at 5% of my account balance and that's more than enough to cover my needs. Well, that's assuming you have a life expectancy between 30 and 40 years. And the earlier you retire, the longer your life expectancy, the more pressure there is on your portfolio to be able to generate that year in and year out. So as you're looking at an early retirement, do you maybe reduce the withdrawal rate to 3.5% or to 3% even, depending on the time that you retire, you want to make sure that you're adjusting your withdrawal rate so you're not taking out too much, because the big risk of retiring early isn't what happens the first 5 to 10 years. It's, are you still gonna have money 20, 30, 40 years down the road after you've been living on your portfolio for that long? Now, the other thing to note is the tax piece, which we kind of just covered. If you're taking 3% of your portfolio or 3.5% of your portfolio, I'm saying, James, I'm gonna be conservative, I'm gonna take less, but I'm gonna retire early, you still have to factor in taxes. That's a 3% total withdrawal. So say, to use a round number, you need $30,000 per year to live on. You say, great, I have $1 million in my traditional IRA. I can go ahead and retire. Well, 3% of $1 million is $30,000, which perfectly meets your living expenses until you factor in taxes. So 3% of that amount, you're gonna be left with a smaller amount once you pay taxes, once you factor in things like that. So make sure that as you're planning for different withdrawal rates, you're looking at what's the maximum amount I can take from my portfolio, what's that amount after taxes, and is that enough to meet my needs? Now, another thing with withdrawal rates is sometimes you can look at it and you can justify taking them out a little bit more upfront because maybe you do take too high of a withdrawal rate. But you know, in a few years, Social Security kicks in, or maybe a pension kicks in, or maybe a rental property is paid off and that increases the cash flow. So it's usually not just a linear equation where you take the same amount of your portfolio each year. There's some planning you can do to say, do you maybe take more out at the beginning before Social Security or pension or rental income or some other income source kicks in, knowing full well that, that withdrawal rate is gonna decrease when that time comes. So as you're looking at retiring early, number one, start with why. Is this retiring early because you really do want to retire and stop working? Or is this retiring early so that you can go work somewhere that you're going to enjoy a little bit more? It's going to be a little bit less stressful. The two of those are going to have very different outcomes or very different planning points. Number two, understand your retirement budget. What's it going to cost for you to retire? Knowing that you might have to come out of pocket for things like health insurance or from some other expenses that a traditional retiree might not necessarily have to do. Number three, understand the rules and taxes and penalties associated with different retirement accounts. Retirement accounts are the IRS's way of helping people plan for a traditional retirement. But an early retirement isn't going to be as easy to plan for and navigate with those, so make sure you understand the rules of where you can access money from. And then number four, understand how this impacts your withdrawal rates. Do you need to decrease your withdrawal rate to account for the fact that this money needs to last longer? Do you still take a higher amount because you know that more income is coming in the future from Social Security or pension or some other source? But if you get these things in place, that's going to be a very close way of getting you to where you need to go to understand if you can retire early. Thanks for watching. This is James Canal with Root Financial Partners. If this video was beneficial to you, please share it. I would love for as many people as possible to see this, to get this information. So if you know someone that could benefit from it, please share this video with them. Also, please make sure to like this video and please subscribe if you haven't already. We release videos at least once or twice a week, and by subscribing, you'll be notified as soon as those come out. And if you want to hear more about how you can create a secure retirement, check out our podcast. It's called Ready for Retirement. We explore more topics about how you can create your secure retirement. And finally, if you want more information on our services, please head over to our website at rootfinancialpartners.com.